everyone, this is MJ with MinIO, and welcome back to the MinIO on Kubernetes and MinIO Operator course. In the last part of the series, we deployed the MinIO Operator using Helm, and we saw that console come up and running, and we were able to access that. In this part of the series, we're going to deploy tenants using Helm, and we will also see those show up in the MinIO Operator UI, as well as get their own tenant consoles. So let's dive right into this. So just like the MinIO operator, we can also deploy MinIO tenants using Helm. You can download the specific tenant Helm chart version that matches the operator version. And you're going to want to make sure you keep these in sync as much as possible, because there will be feature differences that could cause issues if you get too far apart on the tenant and the operator version. So in this course, we will be deploying version 5.0.6. And please make sure that you're using the latest stable version of the MinIO operator Helm charts when you're doing this deployment, as this video that you're watching may be a little bit old. We will run this curl command and basically download this tar.gz file. And once we download this to our local system, we'll actually unpack that. So you can see here that there is a values.yaml contained within this. And so we're going to tar minus zxf and then the name of the tgz file of your tenant operator Helm files. So once we've extracted that, then we can go into the tenant directory that's going to get automatically created when we unzip this. And we will copy that values.yaml file to a new file called tenant1, or whatever you want to call it. But I'm going to call it tenant1-custom-values. That's just to denote that this is a unique file that we've modified for our use case. And in this case, we're creating this for the tenant1. There will be numerous values that you will need to customize for your environment here. So for this course, we're only going to be changing a few, but please make sure that you look at the entire values file. It's likely that as you get into more complex deployments in your systems and in your environments, that you're going to need to be able to understand and modify more and more of the values file to get the outcome that you want for deploying tenants. So we're going to open up the tenant1 custom values YAML that we created. And we're going to update a few things. We're going to update the secret name. We're going to update the access key and secret key. We're going to update the tenant name. We're going to update the configuration name. We're going to update the servers, the number of servers rather, the volumes per server and volume size. We're also going to update the storage class name. So before I go any further, let's jump over and take a look at this file and just see those different fields that we're going to edit. And the later guided exercise, we're actually going to go through and actually modify one of these files. But let's just take a look at the file real quick. So here we are on GitHub, and we're looking at the release 5.0.7. Now we're deploying 5.0.6, but we're going to look at the 5.0.7 version here. It hasn't changed very much. It's a small point version change. But again, you need to make sure that you're matching your values file with the version of the operator, both the operator and the tenant deployments that you're doing, because there will be different values for each of those as the product matures and changes over time. So you'll note here that there is a lot of different things that you can change for the tenant. Again, we're not going to go through all these today. A lot of these are for more complex deployments or for integrations with things like KESS or for other different configurations that you're trying to do. But what we will be paying attention to today is this first thing is the secrets. So we need to update this to be unique secret in our deployment. And in this case, we're going to change this to tenant1 from MyMinIO. We'll also want to update the access and secret key just because we want those to be unique. We don't want them to be this generic MinIO, MinIO123. The next thing we're going to change is the tenant name. In this case, we'll give it tenant1, but of course, you would be calling this the specific tenant you want to deploy. The next thing that we will change is, see this configuration right here? This actually matches up to this secret name up top here. So you can see that this is called MyMinIO and configuration, and down here it's the same. So if you change this one up top here, you need to make sure that you update the bottom here to match that. The next thing we're going to do is to adjust our pools. Now the pools are the storage spaces or storage configuration where MinIO will be deploying this tenant. Now, in our case, we're actually going to be changing this to 1 because we're using a single node deployment and we want to keep it very small, but you will obviously need to customize this based on your environment. So how many Kubernetes servers you have actually up and running, what size the pool is, how much storage space, all that kind of stuff which storage class you're using. So those are the other things we're going to customize here. We're going to change the number of servers. We're going to update the volumes per server to just one. We're going to update our size to increase that size by standard. We're also going to update our storage class name. And that's really all we're going to have to change to get this up and running at a minimal level. So I just wanted to walk through this file with you and let you know that this exists and that you can always go out to at least GitHub and find the latest values file and then import that in and start customizing that for your individual tenants. So now that we've customized the values file, we can now deploy the tenant with the custom values file. So we can do Helm install, create namespace, tenant one, and then we will call this deployment in Helm tenant one. We will refer to that TGZ file that we've downloaded, and this Helm will automatically unpack that and use that for the deployment itself. But we will specify that it, instead of using the default values file built into that, that it should use the values file that we actually created for it. So this is that tenant one custom values file that we've just modified. So now that we've done that, everything should be up and running. We should be able to do a kubectl get pods on the tenant one namespace and see all the pods up and running in there. And we now need to be able to access the tenant deployment. So some things get created by default for internal services to be able to access that. You could do things like port forwarding, as we talked about previously in the operator video. You can also check the documentation for this as well. But we're not going to do port forwarding. Instead, we're going to do a node port service because that's going to be a little bit more persistent access for this. In production, you would likely configure out a DNS name and TLS certificates for this so that the end users are not having to use different ports, different high numbered ports, but rather they're able to just go to a DNS name to access their particular tenant. But in this case, I did want to show you how to at least get initial access to the tenant using NodePort. So what we're going to do is we're going to do kubectl get service tenant one console. So basically a service gets automatically created when we ran that Helm chart called tenant one console. And we actually want to copy that out using the minus O YAML file into this tenant one service.yaml configuration file. Now, what this is going to do is output the Kubernetes YAML that we will need to create another service, but we will need to go in and modify this tenant one service file to actually suit our needs to work as a node port. So we will take a look at that in the walkthrough in just a short bit. So once we've modified that file and actually applied that node port service file, now we can actually get what the node port that was assigned to that was. So we can run this command. Again, don't worry about this. This will be in the link in the description below. We will also show this again in the guided exercise, but this will be the command that you run rather, and it will output the ports, specifically the node port that you need to access from outside your system. So the format will be HTTP, the IP address, and then the node port of the system that you are accessing. And you will sign in using the access and secret key that you defined in your custom values file. So that's really all there is to getting a minimal configuration of a tenant up and running with the MinIO operator. These have been basic steps, and remember that customization will be needed to meet your specific requirements and environment. And as always, please follow the documentation on the website as it will be updated over time. Thanks for watching, and I look forward to seeing you in the next one where we will walk through the guided exercise and I'll show you all the different lab configurations of what we just talked about in these slides.